Hello, dear friends, how are you? I wanted to take really few minutes if you can dedicate from your time to plant the right seeds of light and blessings for the coming month, the month of Pisces, which is the month of Adar. I'm talking about the lunar month. Lunar means the cycle of the moon around the Earth, which is exactly 30 days. And it's important that we plant the right seeds. So basically, the new moon, the new month, is coming Friday and Saturday. And during the month of Adar, it's a very special month. We have Purim. Purim, it's a there's kind of a connection between Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, and Purim. The same way that the Day of Atonement help us to, clean our soul in a very deep way, clean our consciousness. Purim, it's even greater. And that's why, like before, the Day of Atonement, we give special charity called kaparot in order to clean our consciousness completely from all selfish desire to receive for the self alone. Also, before Purim, in order to receive the tremendous light of Purim, the Torah, the Kabbalah is telling us that there is a special kind of charity we give. It's called machatzita shekel, half a shekel, which is a special charity that we give during the month of Adar in order to connect our consciousness to energy of life, continuity, endless blessing, and disconnect ourselves from consciousness of finite, selfishness, dark consciousness, etc. So that's number one. And if you like, you can send me names of people, the name and the father's name. And on the actual day of Purim, we have like a special kind of meal that we do. And I'll have all the names in front of me. I'll mention the names. We'll pray for everyone. So you can send me names. That's number one. And again, soon we're gonna actually do the actual kind of meditation for the month of Adar. Another thing that it's recommended to give during this month of Adar, it's called gift to the poor. It's basically money that we collect, and on the day of Purim, we give it to families in need to support and to give them food to make them happy on the day of Purim. You can give if you can give everywhere you at or you to organization if you know to actual people that needs. But it's important that it will be given on the day of Purim. And if if you don't know or you prefer, you can send it to me and I'll make sure it will go to the right families. And beside that, also it's important, like every lunar month, it's important to know and to inject the right consciousness of continuity and sharing in order that that the entire month will be filled with endless light. Because we know what Rabbi Ashlag teaching us and what Kabbalah teaches us, that in order to be connected to the light force of God, to the endless light and love and blessing and life and positivity and all the blessings of God, we just need to behave like Him. We just need to, God always involved with sharing and caring and influencing good. And when we, that's the consciousness, that's how we want to live. That's how we become one with the Creator. That's how all the blessings become part of our life. So that's why it's important, as I said, to inject the right consciousness and to actually plant seeds for the coming month. So soon I'm gonna also read from the Zohar, but before that, I would like all of us to, to meditate and to actually see and meditate and imagine the entire month of Adar, the entire 30 days. And we're asking the Creator, please, God, help me to actually be part of influence good for others every day of the coming month of Adar, to actually see how during this month of Adar, during the day, throughout the entire day, every day, I'm jumping on opportunities to do good for someone else. And I see myself doing it with so much pleasure, with so much joy. I'm planting the seed that I'm not doing it because I need to, because someone asked me. I'm doing it because it's the ultimate joy. The ultimate joy of God is to share. That's why hopefully we're growing to a place that we understand that the ultimate joy for us is also to share. That's why we see and we ask in the Creator, please God, give me the opportunity throughout the entire month to share and to care and to give and to influence the world with light. We see what's happening in the world. We need to add more light to the world. And we want to see ourselves how throughout the coming month we're going to take so many amazing opportunities of caring and sharing that it's going to create so much light, going to fill the entire world with light. Especially we're of course thinking about Ukraine, the area over there, to stop the war, to bring peace, to bring harmony to Europe, to Ukraine, to Russia, to the Middle East, to the entire world. Also, I would like also to read a section on the Zohar, portion Behar, verse 56. And let's please, listen to the Aramaic words and meditate to strengthen within us the desire to influence good, the desire to share, the desire to care and to love endlessly. מנינון דמי מותר אינון דמתארי איתו בקבלה ולא חסל דילה ואי דקות שברוך הוא יאיב ליתיר כמו דאמר יש מפזר בנוסף עוד מה יתאמה בגין דייתאר ברכה לקבלה ולימה אי אתנה אי אשתה מה יביד למחר לקדוש ברוך הוא יאיב לברכה נבלידה כמה דו כמו So please, let's also now read the translation and, you know, continue to awake consciousness of sharing and caring. It says, come and see. People that have faith, they are the one that leading the Malchut. Means, what does it mean to have faith? People think to have faith, it means to believe in God. But the Zohar says that real faith, yes, of course, believe in God, it's faith, of course. But what the deeper level of faith? Faith, it's when we're doing good, when we're sharing, when we're caring, when we're influencing good for others, by giving charity. So to really believe is when not just that you believe that God loves you, not just that you believe that God exists and is there and is real and loves us and will care for us, but to actually say, if God gives me constantly and all the time, I want to share. I don't want just to receive because God gives me so much love and so much light. I want to give in return. So what does it mean, a charity? Charity, it means that this whole world belongs to the Creator. If I see pain in the world, I say, I don't want pain to exist. Because God, this world belongs to God. I want the world to be a beautiful world. That people are happy. People love each other and love themselves. And everyone is in peace. How do you get there? By giving charity. Giving charity, it's when we actually doing effort to awake positive consciousness in the world, to help people to be connected to the light force of God. That means to give charity. That my charity is in order to bring blessing to the world, to awake the world, to bring the world closer to the Creator. But it's not just enough to give charity. Yes, to give charity it's important. But to give charity and not to be afraid, as Zohar says, of, oh, if I'm giving charity, yeah, great, I want to give charity, I want to bring light to the world, but what about me? If I'm giving charity, I would not have. And the Zohar says, that's exactly the faith that we're talking about. And those people know that God will give them all. It's not about faith anymore, now it's about knowing. We need to get to a level that I know that God loves me. I know that all what God wants is to be revealed. I know that God has endless blessing to give. I know that God cares for me endlessly. That's why I'm not afraid to give. Because in the moment that I'm giving, I have endless light. Nothing is missing. The opposite. More I'm giving, more God can give me. More I'm giving, more God can give me. And that's what we want to inject through our charity. As it says, when you give in charity and you're generous and you do it with love and happiness, God will give you more and more and more. And Rabbi Shimon is saying, don't say, oh, I would not have, I cannot give, I would not have enough for myself tomorrow. The Zohar says, no, don't say that. God will give you blessings without end. Without end. And that's the consciousness that we want to inject, because it's important. Beside all the positive actions that we do, beside the meditation that we just did before, that I want to take opportunities to share and to care and to influence good, because that's how we make sure that the entire month will be filled with endless love and light and blessing and sustenance. But also specifically, as we just learned now, I want to give my monthly charity. I want to give my monthly tithing. What's the whole idea of charity and tithing? That if I'm giving, as the Zohar says, if I'm giving and I'm not afraid, what I'm actually doing, I'm opening my heart. I'm actually releasing energy of unconditional love, because obviously the fear will come. Obviously the evil inclination will come and try to avoid that we would not do it. But if we do it and we inject consciousness and we inject love and we do it with all our heart, it's revealing so much light in the world. It's stopping chaos in the world. It brings miracles to the world. It brings the world closer to God. It allows the light of God to be revealed in the world and to stop all the pain and suffering. Especially for me in my life, because I'm the channel for that. So what I would like us to meditate right now, again, to close our eyes and to meditate, that I'm asking God, dear God, please allow me, help me, strengthen me, so I can give my monthly charity, my monthly tithing. Please, God, help me to manifest it. That I would not be afraid to do it. The opposite, that I'll be so glad. I'll be so glad to do it. I'll be so happy to do it. God, thank you so much for allowing me to be part of making a difference in the world, of bringing light to the world, of helping people and helping the world. It's my merit, it's my pleasure, it's my joy. Thank you, God, for giving me money so I can give my monthly tithing toward adding light in the world. I want to see myself giving this month my charity or tithing, whatever I choose, and I'm doing it with love and happiness, with joy, with certainty, with knowing that not just I would not have less, God actually will give me more and more and more, and more I'll give and more I'll have, and more I'll give and more I'll have. That's how we're filling the world with endless light. It's also important to know that you can give to your tithing or charity. What's the idea? Again, means tithing is great to give, because it's 10%. It's help us to let go completely of all the fears that causing us not to open our heart fully. So if we give tithing, it's help us to remove all those layers, all those clipot, all those shells that are attacking us all the time. Tell us, no, don't give. Don't give you from your time, from your energy, from your love. People will use it against you. No, it's like if you give your tithing, you release yourself from that spiritual jail. And if you choose not to give 10% of your income, it's also okay. You can give whatever amount you give on your charity, which is also beautiful. And you can give your monthly tithing or charity anywhere you like, anywhere your heart tells you. It's supposed to be some place that actually fill the world with light and help the world to become a better place. Of course, you know, I personally, because I'm doing what I'm doing, I myself involved in focusing on my project, which is spreading Zohar, spreading Kabbalah, and teaching the world the teachings of, you know, of Kabbalah, to help people, to give people the consciousness, how to connect to light consciousness, how to connect the world to light consciousness. But you feel free completely, wherever you feel, wherever your heart tells you. But it is important to plant the seed that this month, Adar Bet, second Adar, I'll give my charity. I'll give my tithing. As I'm planting it, I'm already creating this circuitry. I'm already creating this energy of blessing for me and for the world. So wishing everyone Chodesh Tov, a blessed month, a beautiful month. Lots of love.